Dear students, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. How are you? I hope best for you. I, Mukesh Kumar, welcomes you to online, Mukesh Online Academy. आपका मुकेश ऑनलाइन एकेडमी में स्वागत है. And we are doing the science of class 10 from the NCERT book. And we are doing the chapter number 2, that is the acid, base and salt. As you know, this book is mainly followed into the CBSE. Now, whatever board, other boards are also following this book, then those students can also benefit from it. Okay, otherwise, topics are same. Okay, so in India, everybody can get benefit from it. Okay, and we have done this already, this chapter into the previous 11 videos in which we have covered about the indicators, acid-base indicators. We did about the different kind of acids, their properties, then bases, their properties, then we did several questions about them. Okay, then we did about the how strong are acid and base solutions. We did the pH indicator, pH values. Okay, we did the universal indicator. So many things we have done. Okay, in this chapter, I hope you would have seen all these videos. If you have not seen, I have given the links into this description. So it is better if you watch those videos first, then you will be able to understand this video in a much better way. Okay. So, in this video, what we are going to do is the questions depend on which are based on the pH that we did into the last video. Okay. So, I hope you would be understanding, you would be getting knowledge from my videos. And one tip for you, just keep, whenever you are watching any study related video, just keep a notebook, a pen with you. Write the key notes just like you write into the class. So think it like a live class. Okay. So you can think it like a live online class. Okay. And you just start noting the points. So this will help you to make the summary of each and every chapter, which will help you to revise into the exam very quickly. And I hope you must be doing that. Okay. And if you have any doubt, if you have any query about the topic or about the video, then you can write to me in the comment box. Okay. And we'll be solving your queries, okay, through another video. And I hope you must be getting knowledge from my videos. Okay, and if you want to get the free notes of each and every chapter, then also you can write to me along with the practice questions. Okay, you know, practicing the question is good for the subject. Okay, and if you want to do the live interactive online classes, then also you can write to me. So we will be happy to share the details with you, and kindly share it with your friends, subscribe to it, ask your friend to subscribe. And in this video, what we are going to do is the questions based on the pH values. So now let's do it. So dear students, so today in this video, we will do some questions on the pH. In the last video, we had done about the different pH values, hydrogen ion concentration, and the universal indicator that we had discussed. Okay, and now we will do some questions on the pH scale and pH. Okay, so now let's do the first question. See, in this question, we have been given, this is the question from the NCERT book, that you have two solutions A and B. The pH of solution of A is 6 and pH of solution B is 8. Which solution has more hydrogen ion concentration, and which of this is acidic and which one is basic? Okay, so now let's write the answer. We have the one solution A, another solution B. So the pH of solution A is 6. Okay, so the pH of solution A is 6. That means that we have studied that if the pH is less than 7, so that means it will be acidic. Okay, so this solution will be acidic, and pH of solution B is 8, and we had studied if the pH is more than 7, then it will be basic. Now we need to understand then which will have the more hydrogen ion concentration. So we had studied the more the acidic solution is, the more will be the hydrogen ion concentration. So that means the A will have more hydrogen ion concentration than B. Okay, and A will be acidic and B will be basic. So now let's repeat. So pH of solution of A is 6. So that means we had studied that if the pH is less than 7, that it will be acidic. And when it is acidic, then it will have the more hydrogen ion concentration. Now pH of the B is 6. So that means it is the pH more than 7. So it will be basic. Okay. So it will have the less hydrogen ion concentration. So solution A is acidic, have more hydrogen ion concentration, and the solution B is basic and have the less hydrogen ion concentration. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's do the next question. See, in this question too, this is also from the NCERT book. What effect does the hydrogen ion concentration of ions have on the nature of the solution? We have to see the effect of the concentration of hydrogen ion on the nature of the solution. As we had studied that more is the hydrogen ion concentration, the more acidic the solution is and pH will be less. Less is the hydrogen ion concentration, the solution will be less acidic, or rather it can be basic also, and the pH will be more. Okay. So we can write the answer. Higher the hydrogen ion concentration in the solution, more acidic is the solution. Okay. That means pH is less. Okay. Less is the hydrogen ion concentration in solution, less acidic is solution. Okay, means the pH is more. Okay, so as the number of hydrogen ion concentration will increase, the pH will decrease and it will become more acidic. Clear? I hope this is clear to you. Now let's do the next question. This question is also from the NCERT book. Do the basic solutions also have the hydrogen ions? If yes, then why are they basic? Okay, as we had studied into the last video, since water is present in both kind of acidic and basic solutions, and water itself ionizes into the hydrogen ion and hydroxide ions. Okay, so that means both acidic and basic solutions have the both hydrogen and hydroxide ions, but their relative concentrations are different. So that means the basic solutions will also have the hydrogen ions. Okay, then why are they basic? Because the hydroxide ion concentration will be more, and these hydroxide ions come from the ionization of base into water. Okay, so they are basic because the hydroxide ion concentration is more than the hydrogen ion concentration. So that is why they are basic. Okay, so now let's write it. Yes, basic solutions also have hydrogen ion, okay, which comes from ionization of water in which base is dissolved. Okay, they are basic as concentration of hydroxide ions is more than concentration of hydrogen ion. Okay, there is a lot. See, more will be the difference, more it will become basic. Less will be the difference, less it will be the basic. I hope this is understood to you. Clear? Because the basic solutions also have the hydrogen ions which are coming from the ionization of water. Now let's do the next question. Now the next question is, how will you determine the pH of a lemon juice? Okay, lemon juice means nimbu. Okay, so how can we determine it? We will just take a drop of the lemon juice, okay, and put it on the pH paper or universal indicator paper, and the color it will show around the red or orange. Okay, so depending on the concentration of the lemon juice, okay, then it will, that means its pH will be something around 2 or 3, or you can say between 2 and 3 or 2.5. Okay, so this will show the red color or orange red color. So now let's write it. Take a universal indicator paper and put some drops of lemon juice on it. The color of universal indicator paper changes, and this color is matched with colors on pH chart. Means the color chart that we have studied earlier, and we know the pH value. Okay, so what color it will come? As pH of lemon juice is 2.5, so color of universal indicator paper will be red or orange red. Okay, so now let's repeat it. We take a universal indicator paper and put some drop of lemon juice on it, and we check the color of the universal indicator with the pH paper. Okay, so since it has got the pH of 2.5, so its pH most probably will come around the, its color will become red or orange red. So that means this is how we can know the pH of the lemon juice. Now let's do the next question. See, we have the question, 5 solutions A, B, C, D, E, when tested with the universal indicator showed pH as 4, 1, 11, 7 and 9 respectively. So which solution is neutral? Strongly alkaline, strongly acidic, weakly alkaline, and we have to arrange the pH in the increasing order of the hydrogen ion concentration. Okay, now let's write the solutions and their pH. So solution and their pH. Solution A has got the pH 4, solution B has got the pH 1, solution C has got the pH 11, solution D has got the pH 7, and solution E has got the pH 9. So first we have to see neutral. So as we know, the neutral means the pH 7. If the pH is 7, so that means it will be neutral. So that means the D is neutral. So this is neutral. Okay, so the solution neutral is solution D is the neutral solution. I hope this is clear to you. Now they say strongly alkaline. Strongly alkaline means the maximum pH that we can have here. And here we can have the maximum pH as the 11. So that means it is the strongly alkaline. Okay, alkaline. So strongly alkaline, we can see that it is the solution C, because maximum pH, more is the pH, more is the alkalinity. Okay, so C is the strongly alkaline. Strongly acidic, as we know that less is the pH, more is the strong acid. Okay, so here we have the least pH as the 1, so that means this will be strongly acid. Okay, so the acid, so solution B is strongly acidic. Now we weakly acidic means the pH should be less than 7 but towards the more than 4. Okay, 3 or 4 means it should be. So that means the 4 is the pH which is coming into the weakly acidic category here. So it is weakly acid. So here for weakly acidic we can write that solution A. Now weakly alkaline means the pH should be more than 7 but less than 10. Okay, so here we have the 9, so it should weakly alkaline. Okay, so the solution E is weakly alkaline that we have got. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's repeat it again. Neutral. Neutral means the 7 pH, and the 7 pH belongs to the solution D. So that means solution D is the neutral. Strongly alkaline means the maximum pH that we can find here, and it should be more than 10. So we have the 11, so which is strongly alkaline. So which is the solution C is the strongly alkaline. Now strongly acidic means the less than 3 or less. So here we have the 1 pH of the solution B, so that means solution B is strongly acidic. Weakly acidic, that means it should be more than 4, it should be more than 3 or 4, okay. So 4 or more, basically. So it is weakly acid. And this 9 is weakly alkaline because it should be more than 7 but 10 or less. Clear? So this is how we have just categorized them into the different categories. Now arrange the pH in the increasing order of hydrogen ion concentration. Increasing order of hydrogen ion concentration means we have to put them from the more pH to the towards the less pH. What do we need to do? We have to put them from the more pH towards the less pH to increasing order of the hydrogen ion concentration. Increasing order of hydrogen ion concentration means from more pH to less pH. And we have the less pH means you can say the pH more here is 11, then we have 9, then we have 7, then we have 4, then we have 1. So that means increasing order of the hydrogen ion concentration will be solution C, then we have the solution E, then we have the solution D, then we have the solution A, then we have the solution 1 is B. So this is the increasing order of the hydrogen ion concentration. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's do the next question. Now in the next question, we have a solution of acetic acid is highly concentrated. Will you call it a strong acid? Yes, we can call it. Okay, because if the pH is coming 3 or less, so that means definitely it will be a strong acid. But actually, we have learned that acetic acid is a weak acid. Okay, so in fact, we can say it is a buffer solution. Okay, so depending on the amount of water into it, it can be have both as a weak acid also and a strong acid also. So if we dilute it, that means it can be considered as a weak acid. Means it is definitely a weak acid. But if it is concentrated, that means the concentration of the hydrogen ions will become more. So that means the pH will become less. So it will become a strong acid. Okay. So it can cause the blisters. Right. So now let's write it. pH of solution of acetic acid ranges between 2.5 to 4. Highly concentrated solution will have a greater number of hydrogen ions than a diluted solution. It can cause severe burns on the skin. So it can be called a strong acid. Actually, it produces a buffer solution which shows the strong properties when concentrated and weak properties when diluted. Okay, so now let's repeat it. So the pH of the acidic acid ranges between 2.5 and 4. So highly concentrated solution will have the greater number of hydrogen ions than a diluted solution. It can cause the severe burns on the skin. So it can be called as a strong acid. But actually it is what it is doing, producing a buffer solution which shows the strong properties when concentrated and weak properties when diluted. So I hope this is clear to you. Now let's do the next question. So we have the question. Three solutions A and B have pH values 5, 8 and 10 respectively. Among the three, which solution has the maximum hydrogen ion concentration? And classify the nature of these three solutions as acidic or basic. Solution at pH. We have the solution A and pH is 5. Solution B, we have the pH 8. Solution C, we have the pH 10. Okay. So among the three, which solution has the maximum hydrogen ion concentration? Okay. As we have studied, low is the pH, more will be the hydrogen ion concentration. So that means A will have more hydrogen ion concentration. Okay. So what we can write it? Less is pH, more is hydrogen ion concentration. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. So less is the pH, more is the hydrogen ion concentration. So solution A has more hydrogen ion concentration. Okay, now classify the nature of the three solutions as acidic or basic. So definitely if pH is 5, so this will be acidic. Its pH is 8, so it is basic. And its pH is, then it is also basic. But since this pH is 8, so it will be mildly basic. And it will be more basic than B. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Since we have the pH, let's repeat it. Since we have the solution pH, A has the pH 5, B has the 8 and C has the 10. And we have to find which solution has the maximum hydrogen ion concentration. As we have studied, the less is the pH, more will be the hydrogen ion concentration. So the least pH here is the A of solution A. So that means it will have the more hydrogen ion concentration. Then we have to classify the nature of three solutions, acidic or basic. So A has the pH 5, so that means it is acidic. B has the pH 8, means more than 7, so it will be basic. C has the pH 10, so it will also be basic. But solution B has got the less pH than C, so that means the B will be mildly basic and C will be more basic than B. So this is how we can answer this question. Now the next question. So in this question we have, what color would the universal indicator show in an aqueous solution of sugar? And as we know that the aqueous solution of sugar is neutral in nature. Okay, so that means its pH is 7. And when the pH is 7, then it will show the green color as we have studied. Okay, so now let's write it. Its sugar solution is neutral. So it will show the green color on universal indicator paper. Why? Because pH is equal to 7. And for the pH equal to 7, we have the green color. Okay. So dear students, so today we have done different questions related to the pH. And these questions are very important from the exam point of view, because these type of questions comes into the exam. And I hope you would have understood it completely. Okay. So dear students, in the next video, we will do the importance of pH in everyday life. Okay. Like in our mouth, like in our body systems, like in agriculture, like ant sting, like nettle leaf sting. There are so many things, like an acidity. So there are so many effects of the pH or importance of the pH in everyday life that we will study into the next videos. Okay. I hope you would have understood the topic. Okay. So thank you so much for watching. Write your comments about the video, any query, any doubt about the topic into the comment box. Or you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. And if you want to get the free notes of each and every chapter, then also you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. So we will be happy to provide you. And if you want to get the live interactive online classes, okay, where we can interact with each other, facing each other, both group and individual, then also you can write to me. We will be happy to share the details with you. And I hope you must be getting knowledge from my videos. You must be making key notes, okay, and practice the questions, okay. And if you need the practice questions, then also you can write to me. So I'll send you many practice questions, okay. So kindly share it with your friends, subscribe to it, ask your friend to subscribe, and you can follow me on the Telegram and Instagram also, okay. Thank you so much.